exciting news.
With the beast in captivity, the competition can go ahead as planned. You saved the day, Mr. Wallace. Oh,
it was nothing, Your Ladyship.
So modest. Oh, please, do help yourself.
Oh, thanks.
I so appreciate you coming all this way to let me know, Wallace. Tell me, are you a vegetable lover yourself?
They're growing on me.
Then come with me. There's something very special I want to show you.
Oh.
Hop in.
It's very snug.
It's my Jacob's ladder. And it goes all the way to heaven. My inner sanctum, Wallace. My secret garden.
It's a veritable vegetable paradise.
I just knew you'd love it. Unlike Victor, he's never shown any interest in my produce.
Oh, his loss, Lady Tottington.
Please, Wallace, call me Totty. To happen to my vegetables, I don't know what I'd do. I'm sure you understand, Mr. Wallace. I can see that you're a true nature lover.
Oh, yes. Yes, I am.
At first, I thought I could change Victor. Now I'm not so sure. Oh. Do you think a man can change, Wallace?
Change? Oh, yes.
Really, Philip? The things one does for love. Bum, 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 la, da, da, dee, dum, da, da, dee. Pesto.
Mr. Wallace.
Oh, Totty.
Totty?
I'd like to show you one last thing. Something no other man has ever seen. My carotte de Chantenay! Just smell it, Wallace. Feel its silken flesh.
Oh, yes.
Isn't it the most sumptuous, specimen you've ever seen?
Yes.
Doesn't it fill your heart with desire?
Yes.
Just imagine what it would taste like.
What on earth were you thinking of, lad? Ruined a perfectly good piece of fashionable knitwear, that did. To say nothing of a relationship with an important client. Oh, it's lucky for us her ladyship was so understanding. Honestly, I don't know what's got into you lately. And slow down, for pity's sake! You'll buckle me crunions! Don't worry, I'll see to this. You stay here where you belong, in the doghouse. Right. It's heavier than it looks.
I know your little secret, Pesto. I know exactly what's going on.
Your lordship!
Oh, yes. You think you can pilfer my filly, don't you? You think you can con an innocent woman out of her fortune?
Who, me?
Well, I got here first. I've spent a long time reeling in that fluffy-headed bunny lover, and I'm not about to let some puddle-headed peasant poach her from me. Comprene?
Oh, right-o. I'll be off then. Ta-ta.
You're not going anywhere, Pesto.
Oh, ow!
Not until I've taught you a jolly good lesson. Come on, Queensberry rules. Put them up, you little pipsqueak. You're shaking.
Don't tell me you're a scaredy cat as well as a scoundrel. And don't think acting like a big girl's blouse will get you out of it. There's no mercy with Victor Quatermain. What the dickens?
Oh!